searching all along. So you see that we have a tier list. This is for Blade and Sorcery. So I'm going to tell you what the tier list means and then tell you what all those numbers side by the words are. So first we have S is good for all applicable components, which means offense, defense, movement, group attacks and stuff like that. So let's say it's a fireball that doesn't do any movement, so movement wouldn't be applicable. So that means that if it's good on everything other than movement, then it would be able to be there. A good for most components means good for most of the things that are applicable. Obviously B means good for some that are applicable. C means good for few that are applicable. Some is more than few, just so you know. D is good for one component that is applicable, which means that it's only good at one thing. And then F is absolute poop, it's not good at anything, or it's just more like. Now on the right, you see number one is fire OH. That's fire with one hand, lightning with one hand, gravity with one hand, fire with two hands separately, which is fire bar here. And lightning two hands separately, gravity two hands separately. You got fire two hands together. Lightning two hands together, gravity two hands together. 10 is fire on sword, lightning on sword, gravity on sword. 13 is fire on staff, lightning on staff, gravity on staff. So I'm gonna be ranking every power in Blade and Sorcery by the components that I just told you. And then I'm gonna be ranking them by their different variations of use. Haven't played the market map in a while. Right, so here we go. Stop right there. Let me put my screen on. I literally said you could see the numbers right there. The whole time you couldn't see that, guy. So I'll just put a picture there after. Wow, that is horrible. So you're going to be able to see the screen, but not me for a little bit. So look, fire with one hand took two hits, right? So it's good for defense. Offense, I don't know. I mean, I'm saying it's good for offense. Defense, I wouldn't say it's that good for defense. So, by the way, these numbers correspond with these ones, so I have them numbered. So, for defense, it's not much for defense. Because you throw it, then they're still going to be able to come towards you. Unless you hit them in the head. If you hit them in the head, I don't think they die from, I don't think they want to have died from headshot. But I'm pretty sure we'll stumble them back a little bit. So, defense isn't that good. Unless you can defend. It is good. It's all right for killing someone. So I would put fire one hand at a B, just because the aim is also like a little difficult to get the hang of. So it's definitely not that good for defending, because you have to hope that you're good enough to do it right. Now the notes disappear every time I do this, every time I click. So lightning one hand takes years to kill one person, and it's definitely not good for defending. All it's good for, well, it's decent for defending because it can stop them from hitting you for the moment. So if you're on a one-on-one, lightning will be good defense because they cannot move at all while you're zapping them, which is why I will put it, it is good for one component, which is why I'm going to have to give it a D, sadly. Now, fire, why did I get fire B? Because decent for defense. I'm actually going to have to move fire to C. And next we have 3, which is gravity with one hand. Gravity with one hand, it one taps. So attack is automatically. The attack, literally you just hit them once, they're dead. It's also, it can also hit more than one person at once. And fire and lightning are not that good for more than one person, which is why I didn't add anything on for group attacks for them. Now group attacks, I'll add on with, like, after I'm done grading the regular stuff, I'll possibly add on something, but other than that, I won't. And gravity, you can also move with it. Then for defense, you can, it's a bunch of people in front of you. You hit the one in the middle. The other two will get pushed back also. So I would say gravity is an A. Plus it has some, no, gravity is an S, actually. I'm gonna keep it real. Gravity with one hand is an S. And then we got fire with two hands separately. It's really good for defense. It still doesn't do, it still does the same amount of damage, but it's really good for defense. No, it's really good for offense and defense, because offense, you just hit the same person. So that's good. Attack, plus you can kill them quicker, because instead of having to charge up two fireballs, instead of having to charge up a fireball, shooting it, charging up another one, you just charge them both at the same time, shoot one, then they're out of there. So attack is really good for a fireball, two hands separately. Defense is all right, considering, like I said, fire doesn't push them back that much. So for defense, it's not that good. So even though I really like the attack and it's actually pretty decent, I'm gonna have to put it at C. Now, lightning, two hands separately. Attack, still pretty slow, right? But they can't attack you, which leans into defense. Not only that, if it's two people attacking you, then first of all, neither of them can attack you, and then you're getting them killed without any risk of taking any damage at all. So that's really good. And that's also group attack right there. So, 5, which is lightning, two hands separately, I'm going to give it an A. Now we have number 6, which is gravity, two hands separately. And gravity with two hands separately isn't that much. For attack, it's definitely just the same. Because attack is literally, you know, one hit. So attacking one person with it, you won't even use both, rendering it useless to use both, and then it's removed from that. Right? Now, gravity, two hands separately, the movement is amazing because you jump as high as you can, then shoot yourself up twice. So the movement is out of this world, right? Now for defending, just like the first, defending is going to be good because defending, somebody's running up on you, like I said, you hit the middle person, all of them might get pushed back, right? But if you got two, you can just boom one, and if anybody's still there, you do the other one, you're good. So gravity, two hands separately, is going to get an A for the fact that its attack is pretty much the same and doesn't change that much. Now we're going to move on to the next few, which is two hands together, then on a sword, and then on a staff, right?
Yeah. I just hit myself.
fireball. Yeah, we need some more. Probably. Hey, why did I have a fetch? So we are back. Yeah, that was fun. Right? Okay. Let's go. Regular? Now, what do we do? We do 1 through 6. Now we gotta do 7 through 15. Alright, 7. Fire, two hands together. Attack. Literally, just throw it at somebody. One hit. Right? Defense. Defense, if anybody, if they're grouping around, just throw it at the ground. They're all going to get hit. It's a blast attack, right? Movement, you can also do a little bit of movement with it. So that component is valued. Group attacks is really good. So I'm expecting most of the two hands togethers to get higher ratings than their previous ones. Lightning two hands together. Same as fire two hands together, except there's no movement. You literally just pull your hands apart and you just shoot a ray. And it actually does damage, so we're gonna give that an S as well. Now we have gravity two hands together. Attack. I'm pretty sure that was the one. No, two hands together, attack. It's not really good for attack, but it's good for defense. Movement. It's not good for movement. It's good for the enemies to fall slower so they take less fall damage, but that's not what you want. So, movement. I will say movement is applicable because gravity causes stuff to move slower if they're affected by it. So, gravity, two hands together, which is 9. Is going to get a B, to my surprise, to everyone's surprise. Now, fire on a sword, attack, it can literally pierce through their shields, it can pierce through the shield, you know, it pierces through the shield, pierces through armor, literally, is just the highest damage doing. So that's gonna get an S. Now lightning on a sword. The sword doesn't get much stronger. So for attack, it zaps them a little bit after you hit them. But unless you get a good hit, then the zap is not gonna kill them. So attack would be pretty much like if I had to rate the attack 1 through 10, that would be pretty much well, compared to a regular sword, it'd be pretty much basically it's the same as a regular sword, just with some extra zap, which barely does anything, so it's low. But if you hit them with it, yes, they zap. And the thing is, if you hit their weapon, like if your weapons intertwine, like if your sword hits their sword, then their sword will have lightning, which means they'll do more damage to you, even though it's not that much, it's something. So 11. is actually going to be negative in defense. It's not that good. Good for a few components. I wouldn't say that. I would say lightning on a sword is horrible. Now, I know it's probably called thunder because lightning is like the sound. No, it is lightning. Well, I don't know. Now, gravity on a sword. Gravity on a sword isn't much. You hit them. And I think it makes... No, when you hit them, their whole body is open for telekinesis. So, usually you can only get their, like, legs, wrists, or the head area. But you hit them with that, then they're, like, every part that is able to do it will be able to do it. And it will show more. Other than that, you hit their weapon. Other than that, you decapitate them with it. Then their head floats really slowly. If you get a final blow off of it, like you kill them with a strike of that, then their body will like fall slower. So it's really just cosmetic. It's not much. I have to give it a D. 13. I'm pretty sure this is staff now. Yeah, fire on a staff. For attack, it's pretty good. For defense, pretty good because the balls just swarm and hit all the nearby targets. Movement isn't applicable. Group attack is applicable. So we're going to give that S. Lightning on a staff stuns. So that's good for when you're, if they're grouping up against you, you just use the thunder and then you can like take them off while they're getting stunned. Now I would have put like killing them while they're stunned on the attack. But you're not going to stun them unless they're coming towards you. You're not going to run up to them, stun them, then kill them. You're just going to run up to them and kill them if you're aggressing. So the attack isn't much because the stun will not kill them no matter what. It'll literally just stun them and get them lower health, I'd say. But even that isn't, you know, very accurate. So I would have to say they are a B, sadly. And last, gravity on a staff. Gravity on a staff it's not bad, but it isn't much. You hit the ground, then it pushes everybody back. So that's perfect for defense. But for attack, it's not like you're going to be able to hit them while they're flying away. Because they're going to be not too hard to reach, but it's going to be too much of a hassle to reach them. So at that point, you might as well just fight using pure skill. Movement, of course. Gravity on a staff doesn't cause any movement, but since it's gravity, movement is going to get put into that no matter what, because you're making energy. You're putting the enemies further away from you, which is also taking your attack down more and putting their movement up some, which you're probably like, come on, bro, you're really adding that in. Yes, I am. So gravity on a staff, despite gravity probably being my favorite on all of these, because 3, 6, 9 and 12. 12 is low. 9 is decent, you know. Gravity might be my favorite. You know. But this is not my bias. It's like how we actually do. So gravity on the staff. Decent for defending and regrouping. But even then, you know, it's not that much in your favor. So I have to say gravity on the staff is absolute poo-poo. That's what I genuinely would have to say. I would have to say it's absolute poo-poo. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. You might not have enjoyed my ratings, but, you know, everybody has an opinion. You don't like my ratings, then I understand. Yeah. Comment down below what you would have put any of these, if you would have put them higher or you would have put them lower. If you think I added on some BS extra stuff, being like, well, gravity always has to be a part of movement, so since it has no movement for you, it's absolute poo-poo, because that is one of the main reasons I put it down there. But, you know, if you have anything to say, you know, just comment down below. I read the comments. That I was going to forget.
summer nights can even turn cold. In the streets of Philly where niggas don't even get to turn old. My heart pumping to it, turn gold.